Hi friends, if you like my videos, subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon for the latest updates.
So in this video, let us discuss about cell suspension culture. So coming to the basic principle of this cell suspension culture. So remember students, I am going to explain you about only the cell suspension culture and the procedure of this culture. And there will be two types of this cell suspension culture. They are batch culture as well as the continuous culture. And the batch culture and as well as this continuous culture will be explained in next video. So in this video, I am going to just explain you the procedure and the diagrammatic representation of the cell suspension culture. So coming to the principle. The basic principle of the cell suspension culture is isolation of large number of cells and culturing them on a nutrient medium for growth and development. So you can understand this principle when I explain you the procedure. So firstly, let us switch on to this procedure. So here in the procedure, what is the main aim of the cell suspension culture is that it mainly helps in the production of the secondary metabolites. So what are secondary metabolites? So how it will be produced? So what is the main mechanism behind the production of the secondary metabolites? So it will be produced from the primary metabolites. So how these primary metabolites and how this function, how the function of this bioreactor occurs. So what is bioreactor actually? So this will be your bioreactor, and this bioreactor plays a major role in the production of the secondary metabolites. So here, from here, the primary metabolites, which is in the form of a medium, will get added, and then the production of the secondary metabolites will get protruded out from the outlet of this bioreactor tank. So before explaining about this deeply about this bioreactor, firstly let us see the procedure of the cell suspension culture, and then let us come to this principle as well as this bioreactor explanation. So what is the first step which you are going to perform in the procedure of the plant tissue culture selection of a mother plant? We know that, and even if you see my previous videos of plant tissue culture technique and the protoplast culture, each and everything, I explained you briefly about the how the plant tissue culture will be performed and what is the first step which you are going to do in the plant tissue culture selection of a mother plant. So how that mother plant will be selected by the proper development of the shoot system as well as the root system, and from that shoot system you are going to take a leaf. Not only the leaf, you can also take flowers also, and you can also take the meristem. It depends upon your wish. And now here I am going to take a leaf, and normally for every tissue culture technique, leaf will only be taken. So here I am going to take a leaf, and now that leaf will get cut into a small piece. I mean, you know, particular piece of this leaf will get extracted or isolated, and that extracted one is called as an explant. Right, we know that. So now this explant will be taken in a proper test tube, which is consists of this agar medium. So now you have to take a test tube, and within the test tube you have to place this agar medium, and within that agar medium, this explant which you have cut from this leaf should be placed into this agar medium which is present in the test tube. Right, so in the next step, what you have to do? So now there is no proper doing of this, because it itself will form a callus. Right, formation of callus occurs. And now what you are going to do with this callus? So now this test tube consists of the agar medium as well as the callus formation, presence of the callus. Now what you have to do is that now you have to shake the test tube here like this. You have to shake the test tube vigorously. So what happens when you shake this test tube along with these contents? Then this callus will get broken down, right? So how the callus will be formed actually? By the rapid cell division. With the help of a cytokines which is present in this agar medium. Okay, not only this agar medium not only consists of this agar solution, but also it consists of some other nutrients like cytokines, all of these plant growth hormones, nitrogen, phosphorus. There are many type of nutrients which will be present in that. So among them, cytokines is one of them, right? So with the help of the cytokines, it leads to the formation of a callus. And in that way, the callus will be formed, where we all of us know that, which I have explained in the plant tissue culture technique itself. So now this callus, here we are going to shake the test tube properly. So once you are going to shake this test tube, this arrow marks which I have drawn indicates that you are going to shake this test tube up and down or side by side like that. So when you shake this test tube, then this callus which has been present in this medium will get broken down to form a mass of an individual cells. It will get broken down into individual cells. So if you see here, it is a mass of cell which has been present together like a stuff, right? So now when you shake this properly up and down, then what happens? It will get divided. I mean, it will get separated to form a mass of individual cells, right? So now this mass of individual cells along with that medium will be taken in another fresh test tube. Right, individual cells should be taken in a test tube. And now what you have to do? Now this test tube which consists of this material will get centrifuged. Right, centrifuge is nothing but the process of the centrifugation, where it forms the two layers. I mean, centrifugation is a process where it undergoes a process where it mainly forms the two separate layers, right, when you place in a centrifuge machine. So we know about the centrifugation. And now here when you do the centrifuge, then what happens is that when you do this centrifugation, then immediately these all of these separated layers will form a layer at the below, you know, at the below of the test tube, the bottom of the test tube, and at the upper column of the test tube, the remaining solution of this agar medium and the nutrient medium basically will be present at the upper column, whereas at the bottom of this test tube, all of the separated mass of the cells will get presented over there, right? So here the precipitate will get settled at the bottom. That's what I have written here. So now what you have to do in the next step? So now you have to take an agar plate. Firstly, you have to take a petri plate, and in that petri plate you are going to place an agar solution. And now what you have to, and that plate is called as an agar plate. And now here the precipitate has been formed after the centrifugation process, we know that. And now this precipitate will be placed properly on this agar plate. Right? So these are the individual cells. The green color dotted like structures which I have drawn are known as precipitates, which has been formed by the centrifugation process. And these are called as individual cells, which has been placed in the agar plate. So after this step, what you have to do? Now you have to incubate this, incubate this agar plate. Incubate is nothing but the process of the incubation, so that what happens is that after some time, then immediately these individual cells will get developed into cell colonies. Will get developed into cell colonies, right? It will become larger in size and forms a cell colonies. And now from the cell colonies, you are going to select more productive clones. More productive clones is nothing but which is highly reactive and which is highly functional. Only those will get selected. And that the main phenomena which you are going to use for the production of this, for the selection of these productive clones are clone pigmentation. That is one method which you are going to perform for the selection of these productive clones. Productive clones is nothing but the selection of the functional clones. I mean more effective, which is more, which gives more perfect result. Only that type of clones you are going to select. So all of these are the clones which are in the form of a cell colonies like this. Okay, if the name itself indicates colonies, cell colonies. Okay, so now that selected productive clones will get transferred into the bioreactor. Bioreactor is nothing but the machine which I have said you at the beginning, right? That is called as a bioreactor. And now once these productive clones will get transferred into the bioreactor, then immediately it leads to the formation of the secondary metabolites. Then the secondary metabolites will get protruded out from the bioreactor. And now here you are going to induce these all of these substances into the bioreactor, right? And those substances are called as a primary metabolites. So from the primary metabolites, the secondary metabolites will get protruded, will get produced or else, and with the help of a bioreactor. So now let us learn about the bioreactor. So what is bioreactor actually? Bioreactor is a biomachine in which it mainly helps in the conversion of a primary metabolite to the secondary metabolites. Right, so primary metabolites is nothing but the cell colonies. In this case of cell suspension culture, I am saying you, this bioreactor not only used for the cell suspension culture students, it is also used for many other purposes also. But as I am explaining, in this case of a cell suspension culture, here the cell colonies acts as a primary metabolites, which consists of the agar medium. And now that medium which consists of the cell colonies will get induced into this bioreactor. Right, so actually first let us learn about the what are the parts which are present in this bioreactor. So here this is called as agitation machine, and this is called as pH controller, and this is called as foam breaker, and these are the blades, flat blades, and these blades only play a major role in this bioreactor machine, which mainly helps in breaking down of these primary metabolites to the secondary metabolites. And here this is a thermal jacket. So what is meant by this thermal jacket? It mainly helps in the maintaining of the temperature which is present in this bioreactor. Okay, so now this is a reactor tank. Reactor tank is nothing but where the reaction of this occurs. I mean the primary metabolite to the secondary metabolite is a reaction, right? And that reaction occurs in this reactor tank only. Here this is a diffuser, and now here this will be your tap. I mean when this conversion of this primary metabolite to the secondary metabolite occurs, then it will get settled in the bottom, right? So when you know that it is settled in the bottom, then slowly you are going to open this tap. And once you open this tap, then slowly the secondary metabolites will get sent out through this outlet. In this way you will get your secondary metabolites as a product. So now this is a air inlet. So here air inlet is nothing but we are going to send oxygen gas into this bioreactor, so that the proper functioning of this bioreactor occurs in such a way that proper production of the secondary metabolites also occur. So here this is your feeding pump. Feeding pump is nothing but from which you are going to feed this cell colonies, I mean the primary metabolites. So here actually there will be a small tank here, and this small tank is nothing but where you are going to place the medium. Medium is nothing but this all of the cell colonies. So here there will be again a small tap, and when you open this tap, then immediately slowly a small amount of medium will get transferred into this reactor tank. I mean this bioreactor tank, and it performs its function. So this I have said you that these are the flat blades, right? So these flat blades will get rotated, and once it starts rotation, then immediately these blades may cut, or else it will get metabolized, this primary metabolite to the secondary metabolites, and now secondary metabolites will be formed, right? And the secondary metabolites will be sent out through a form of a like this disc, which is called as an outlet. From this outlet, the secondary metabolites will get protruded out, and that secondary metabolites is mainly used for the scientific fiction process, which is mainly used for the researchers process. I mean, it is also used for the education purpose. I mean, what are the main functions of the secondary metabolites? What are the applications of the secondary metabolites? So actually, how it is used, for what it is used, for each and every purpose, the secondary metabolites are mainly used, right? So here, one more important thing which you have to remember is that, so here I have said you that there will be a production of the cell colonies, and from the cell colonies you are going to select these productive clones, right? And now this productive clones has a two ways. I mean, the first way is that it is mainly useful for the sending it to the bioreactor for the production of the secondary metabolites. This is one way. And in the second way, what you are going to do? In the second way, the cell colonies are also used for the production of another cycle of this, what we say, this culture medium. I mean, here again you are going to culture that these productive clones which are going to select, and when you culture it again, you are going to select it as an explant, where you are going to place it in agar medium, and even it will get formation of a callus, and even the total life cycle will get repeated in such a way that it mainly leads to the formation of a plantlet. And once that plantlet will form, it will get transformed into a pot which consists of the soil, and it will get properly developed. Properly developed is nothing but where the shoot system as well as the root system will get properly developed, and it will get transported to the farmers. It will get supplied to the farmers. So this will be about your cell suspension culture, and this cell suspension culture will be of two types, which I have said you, that is batch culture as well as the continuous culture. So that batch culture and continuous culture will be explained in next other video. So this will be about your cell suspension culture, students, and for the notes of this cell suspension culture will be given in the WhatsApp group, and the invite link of that WhatsApp group will be given in the description box, and remember that notes will be in a written form which I have written it. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, just do like and subscribe, and if you have any doubts regarding this video, you can comment in the comment box, or else you can ask in the WhatsApp group itself. Thank you.